How did a tiny bar in Pittsburgh end up hosting legendary acts like Bruce Springsteen, Aerosmith, the Ramones, Stevie Ray Vaughan, and the Red Hot Chili Peppers? Keep watching for the story of the decade. The corner of Atwood and Senate Street was once home to the Decade, one of Pittsburgh's most legendary music venues. From 1973 to 1995, the Decade served as a place for local rock bands to make a name for themselves and eventually became a national showcase for some of the biggest rock bands. On October 22, 1973, a Pitt grad, Dom DeSilvio, bought the property, which at the time was called Pizza Pub, and converted it into a 1950s doo-wop-themed restaurant, which was said to hold 400 people. As time changed and rock music became more and more popular, DeSilvio started booking live rock acts at the Decade. The first regular headliner at the Decade was a country rock group called Gravel. Eventually, Gravel broke up, and they split off into their own groups such as the Tigers and the Silencers, who would eventually come back and play gigs at the Decade. The next band to regularly headline at the Decade was a group called the Iron City House Rockers, led by guitar player Joe Krushecki. They were known to pack the bar every weekend that they played there. Like many of the other house bands that played at the Decade, the Iron City House Rockers signed to a major label and released critically acclaimed records in 1979, 80, and 81. Their most successful record was called Have a Good Time, But Get Out Alive. The shift from local rock club to national showcase took place in 1978. This is when a concert promoter named Danny Kresge got in touch with the owner of the Decade, Dom DeSilvio, with the idea of converting the bar into a showcase for nationally touring acts, similar to the Whiskey A Go-Go Club in LA. This is when things started to get big at the Decade. In March of 1979, Kresge booked the legendary punk rock group The Ramones to play back-to-back nights at the Decade.
We are the Ramones, and this one's gonna rock the way it be.
This was the first national act to play at the Decade, but there would be no shortage afterwards. A couple weeks later, the Police stopped by while they were touring on their song Roxanne, which was just gaining national popularity. Apparently, the frontman for the Police, Sting, complained about the size of the stage at the Decade. You can even see the drummer, Stuart Copeland from the Police, wearing a Decade t-shirt in the music video for their song Message in a Bottle, which came out the following year. Other acts like Joe Jackson,
is she really going out with him?
Pat Benatar,
heaven with the best shot.
Sidney Lauper,
oh, girls just wanna have fun.
And later on, a very up-and-coming U2. One of the most beloved up-and-coming acts to perform at the Decade is legendary blues guitar player Stevie Ray Vaughan. According to legend, promoter Danny Kresge first saw Stevie Ray Vaughan at a club in New Orleans. He was so amazed by his performance that he asked if he'd be willing to come up to the Decade in Pittsburgh. Vaughan agreed to play the show for just $500, and prior to that he had never traveled north of Georgia. In 1985, the still pretty underground Red Hot Chili Peppers performed there to what was apparently a 10-person crowd. After gaining such a great reputation over the span of just about 6 years, huge artists would often stop in the Decade just for the atmosphere. One night after playing a show at the Civic Arena in Pittsburgh, Bruce Springsteen was convinced to stop in the Decade by former frontman of the Iron City House Rockers, Joe Krushecki. Other rockers such as John Bon Jovi and Aerosmith made similar surprise appearances to the Decade in its heyday. Unfortunately, the good times did not last there. Owner Dom DeSilvio was forced to file for bankruptcy in 1986 after he failed to pay his taxes. The Decade continued to host local acts up until 1995, which is when it officially closed. Since then, the location has gone through a few different owners, but today is the site of the Garage Door Saloon. The Decade will go down as a legend in the history of the Pittsburgh music scene, There's even live records and books which you can check out if you're interested in finding out more about the decade. If you enjoyed this video and you'd like to see more content like this, please leave a comment and make sure you subscribe so you won't miss the next Pittsburgh Music Venue video. I'm a little lover boy.